This video is about Microsoft Copilot. So here I'm talking about what was earlier known as Bing Chat Enterprise. If you have any of these M365 or business licenses, you have Microsoft Copilot already with you. You can do amazing things like summarize PDFs instantly, summarize videos instantly, draft complex emails, compare your product specifications with competitors without wasting time browsing data, and so many more things. Now, if any of these are relevant to you, make sure you watch the video till the end. Now, you will say all these things I could have done in ChatGPT and a regular Bing chat as well. What is this Copilot doing extra for me? Yes, it is giving you ChatGPT DALL-E 3 only, but Bing Chat Enterprise gives you a layer of data protection. In simple terms, what does it mean? The data which is put in chat is not stored by Microsoft or OpenAI. It is not used for training any AI system, or it is not saved at all. So commercial data protection. So now that the security concerns are taken care of, let's focus on productivity. Yes, bing.com/chat. That is the easiest way to use Bing Chat Enterprise. But that's just Bing Chat. You have to log in using your work ID. Then it becomes Bing Chat Enterprise. How do I know it is there? You will see this green message saying your data is protected. There is another way of doing it. In fact, I would suggest this as the recommended way. Use Edge browser, and in the Edge browser, you create a profile, and in the profile, you log in using Work ID. And then there is an Edge Copilot pane. What is the benefit of this setup? Your login is taken care of, and while you are browsing other things, you can use Copilot. This is another problem I see across customers. All of them have Edge installed. But if you go to individual users, many people are still not using Edge. Why? So I'm not forcing you to use a particular browser, but if you're working on Microsoft platform, use Edge. For everything else, do whatever you like. Let's see the first scenario. I have a PDF file open. Edge opens PDF files without any extension. We know that now. So this is a very long PDF file and I want a summary. I just say summarize and the job is done. But wait, there is a better way of summarizing. So I'm going to say summarize this PDF in 10 points. And now, of course, it'll do its job. Did it save time? Yes. Did it protect your data? Yes. Best of both worlds. The next one is similar, about summary only, but about videos. This is a 1 hour long video. It still created a summary beautifully. Now, of course, this is done in ChatGPT directly? No. For that, we have to go to ChatGPT, install add-ins. There are many add-ins which work, but this is happening right within your browser with data protection. Now you'll say, what is the data protection required for YouTube? I agree, YouTube is anyway public. But you could have some private videos there, or more importantly, you may have corporate videos on Stream. I hope you are using Stream for corporate learning and development kind of videos. If not, have a look at this video. The idea is any video with captions will be summarized by Copilot. So use it to your advantage. Corporate videos lying in LMS, put them in Stream, and now they are searchable and summarizable. You never had that benefit. Imagine how you can enhance learning across the organization just by using this feature. Now, the third one improves your communication. Whether you are writing an article or a proposal or an email or a blog or script for a video, so all that you have to do is copy-paste your content in the chat and ask it to rephrase it the way you want. So the same specs, for example, can be rephrased as a tagline, or as a blog article, or as an informative email. This is the creative capability of LLM, which is now available to all corporates without exposing their sensitive data. So when you go to compose anything, it gives you multiple tones, multiple kinds of output formats, and allows you to control the length. So you literally have a creative writer along with you without exposing your data. Now the next one is using your data and outside data. Let's say I have my specifications for the product and I want to compare those with my competitors. Typically, what would I have done? My specs I already have. I would have spent hours sitting and sifting through internet, got the specs and then put them somewhere, copy-pasted and then tabulated them, and then I would have compared. Obviously, it's a time-consuming and tedious process. Now I'm getting best of both worlds. I'm using my data in a confidential way. but I am getting the global intelligence of ChatGPT. Now let's look at the visual part of it. Let's take a routine scenario. Monthly, I create a review presentation. This month, there is a theme. Now put that theme into Copilot and ask it to create a visual. If nothing else, whatever visual comes, and if you like it, put it as the first slide. Remember, the first slide is looked at longest. So maybe it'll have a good impact. Now from IT point of view, this is completely governed. Go to Admin Center, go to this page, and you can control Copilot. And lastly, I'll tell you the difference between this Copilot and Microsoft 365 Copilot. As you know, M365 Copilot, you have to have $30 and minimum 300 users and all that. Now, what is that going to give you in addition to this Copilot? Well, complete and direct integration with Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, OneNote, all the Microsoft 365 apps. So, bottom line, if you have any of these M365 or business licenses, you have Microsoft Copilot already with you. So start using it, popularize it, share this video with all users, and trust me, your productivity will grow. Let me know your experience. And before you go, I have these videos about Word and PowerPoint Copilot. Have a look at them as well.